Oi, Fernanda.
So, can you see this problem statement?
Yes, ma'am.
This problem statement I have written. Write the Boolean expression for the logic diagram given below and simplify it as much as possible and draw the logic diagram that implements the simplified expression. Okay? So here, write the Boolean expression for the logic diagram. So logic diagram is given. For this, so how to write the Boolean expression now? Can anybody help me in this writing this Boolean expression? So here, first we write AB, we get AB here. Next we get here at the output of the second AND gate, we get BC. At the output of the third AND gate, we get AB. Here at the output of the first OR gate, we get A plus AB. At the output of the second OR gate, we get B plus BC. At the output of the third OR gate, we get C plus AB. And at the output of the last AND gate, we get ANDed of these three terms. That is A plus AB ANDed with B plus BC ANDed with C plus AB. So we get this expression at the output of the logic network, right? So here, what the question is told, write the Boolean expression for the logic diagram given below. Logic diagram is given. For this, we wrote the Boolean expression. Next, it tells, simplify it as much as possible and then draw the logic diagram. So for this expression, we need to simplify it. We need to simplify it. Okay. So after simplifying, what we get the expression? No. For that, we need to draw the logic network. Okay. So I'll rewrite the same expression once again. A plus AB into B plus BC into C plus AB. We need to simplify this. So I just multiply the terms. A into B, I'll get AB plus A into BC, I will get ABC plus AB into B, I will get ABB plus AB into BC, I will get ABBC. Last one, let it remain as it is, C plus AB as it is. Okay, so next what we have to do, see here, AB plus ABB is nothing but this is AB only, right? So it becomes AB plus AB. What it becomes? AB plus AB is AB only. AB plus ABC plus ABBC. What this becomes? ABBC becomes ABC. ABC plus ABC will become ABC only. 1 plus 1 is 1 only. Similarly, ABC plus ABC is ABC only. Into, write it as it is, C plus AB. Okay, is it clear? So here, next I will take In this term, AB I will take common. AB into 1 plus C. Okay. So here C plus AB, I will keep it as it is. AB into 1 plus C. What is 1 plus C? It is 1 only. So AB into 1 is AB only. AB into C plus AB. The third term I am keeping it is as it is. This gives me ABC plus ABB, isn't it? This gives me ABC plus, I'll write it AB. BC plus AB, AB. So it will give me AABB. It will give me AABB. Right? So here ABC plus AABB will give me AB. It will give me AB. Next I will take AB common. AB into bracket C plus 1. It will give me AB only. Okay? It will give me AB only. So for this reduced expression, no, I have to draw the logic diagram. So that is A and B, A, B, AND gate with output Y. So this is the reduced expression. So this is how you need to solve an example. Okay. So logic network is given. For that logic network, you need to write the Boolean expression. After writing the Boolean expression, reduce it. Okay. Reduce it. After reducing, you get one expression. So for that, you write the logic network. This completes the solution of this problem. Okay. So demorganize this Boolean expression given. So we will solve some examples. The first example, demorganize f is equal to a plus b bar into c plus d bar whole bracket. Now we need to use the De Morgan's theorem. So now, as the De Morgan's law state that break the bar and change the sign. So entire bar is there, no? Break it. Break it here at the middle and change the sign. Here it is AND. So we'll change AND to OR. So how do we do it, students? Listen to me carefully. A plus B whole bar. Break the bar. It was AND. Now it will become OR. Okay. Next, C plus D bar. Break the bar. Okay. What is the rule of demorganize? Break the bar and change the sign. Next, again, apply De Morgan's law here. Okay. So what I will get? See, break the bar. A bar. Here it was plus. It will become AND. AND into B double bar. Plus as it is. Here I will break the bar. C becomes C bar. ORing becomes AND. D double bar. Okay. So here, see, A bar as it is into B. Why? Because double bar means it will give the same value B. Plus C bar into D double bar means D. So is equal to A bar B plus C bar D. Further, we cannot simplify. So this is a simplified expression. This is the simplified expression. So this is the first example we have solved using De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law states that break the bar and change the sign. Change the sign. So change the sign means if it was previously plus, make it AND. If it was previously AND, make it plus. Okay. So your entire bar was broken up. Middle it was AND, it become break the bar and change the sign. Next, here we will apply De Morgan separately. For this separately, for this separately. So A bar, it becomes A bar, break the bar. It was previously it was OR, it became AND. A bar into B double bar plus C bar into D double bar. So A bar into B plus C bar into D. So we have De Morgan's theorem to the expression F is given as AB bar into CD plus E bar F into AB bar plus CD bar. Close the bracket and give an entire bar to this. Now we need to solve this using De Morgan's theorem again. In the second example. So again, break the bar and change the sign. So what we will do here, this is equal to AB bar as it is, I will keep CD plus E bar F as it is, I will keep. I'll break the bar here. Here it was AND, so it became OR here. And again break the bar. AB whole bar plus CD whole bar. Okay. Next, again I will break the bar for this term, okay, is equal to AB. See, AB bar it was, break the bar. Here it is AND, so it become plus. So CD plus E bar F, break the bar, plus AB. See here, AB double bar, CD double bar. Okay. So what happens here? Break the sign in between. AB double bar plus becomes AND CD double bar. Okay. CD double bar. Next here it becomes AB. This becomes AB plus. Here again apply De Morgan's theorem here. Break the bar here. CD bar, or it was, it became F. E bar F into bar plus, here it will become double bar, it becomes AB, this becomes CD, so this becomes A, B, C, D. Okay, so next here, this is equal to AB as it is. Again apply De Morgan's theorem here. CD bar is there, no? Break the bar here. It becomes C bar plus D bar. Okay. Next again apply here De Morgan's theorem. E double bar plus F bar plus A, B, C, D. Okay. So lastly, can you see, can I reduce anywhere? AB as it is plus C bar as it is plus D bar as it is into E double bar, so it becomes E plus F bar plus A, B, C, D. So I think this is the final answer. So this is the final expression for the second problem. So what we have done is we have applied the De Morgan's law, break the bar and change the sign. So it was entire bar was there here. We have broken it. Previously it was add. We have become more. You have broken the bar and change the sign. So first you make half half. Next internally you try start making breaking the bars and change the sign up till you get the reduced expression. See, here it is A B C D E F. Here it is A B C D. So I think further reduction cannot be possible. If possible, you try it. Okay. So this is some reduced expression for the above Boolean expression given. Okay. So next, I will go to solve the next problem. Third one, third example. Reduce the expression. Reduce the expression. Write down everybody. Reduce the expression. F is given is equal to AB bar plus A bar plus AB whole bar. Okay. So this is the example given. Just try to solve this. So here, listen to me. I will try to break the bar. See, AB double bar. This becomes and A double bar. This becomes and AB bar. Correct. So this becomes AB. This becomes A. This becomes AB bar. AB into A. What it is? AB. This is AB bar. When I multiply AB into complement of AB, that is AB bar, A into A bar equal to 0. B into B bar is also equal to 0. When I multiply AB into complement of AB, into complements of it, that is AB bar, you will get 0. Answer is 0. I hope everybody got this. Fine. So moving on to the next example. Reduce the Boolean expression. Reduce the Boolean expression given. F is equal to A into B plus C bar. AB plus AC bar So the Boolean expression is given. You need to reduce it using laws, axioms, and give me the answer. What is the answer for this? All of you try to solve this. A, B plus C bar as it is, demorganizes AB bar into AC bar whole bar, demorganizes. Next, again, write the expression, rewrite it as A into B plus C bar. Again, demorgans, break the bar, change the sign, A bar plus B bar, this will become. This will become A bar plus C double bar means C. Next, you write it as it is. Rewrite the expression and solve it. B plus C bar. A bar into A bar. I am multiplying the terms inside the bracket. Plus A bar into C plus A bar into B bar plus B bar into C. Okay. Next, A plus B plus. Try to multiply the term C with the brackets inside term. So this will become A bar C bar plus A bar C into C bar will be 0. No, C into C bar is 0. bar, B bar, C bar plus C bar into C, the last term, C bar into C into B bar is 0 only. So write it as 0. A into into the bracket B plus A bar C bar A bar C bar plus A bar B bar C bar So you multiply the term AB plus A into A bar into C bar plus A into A bar into B bar into C bar. So A into A bar is 0. Here also A into A bar is 0. What remains? Only AB. So this is equal to AB. So this is the solution for the particular Boolean expression given. See, Boolean expression, you can use De Morgan's law or you can use A into A bar axiom. You can use anything. Wherever you feel that De Morgan's law should be used, wherever bar is there, a complete bar is there, I think there you can use a De Morgan's law. Otherwise, you can use some axioms, laws. Okay, so here in this particular example, we have used the laws also and De Morgan's law also. Laws and axioms, both we have used. And we have reduced the expression. We have got AB. Okay, so next example, fifth example, write down everybody, reduce the Boolean expression, reduce the Boolean expression. Given F is equal to A plus B into AC plus B plus C bar into D. Reduce the following expression. Okay, so what you do is A plus as it is you write. Okay, so you multiply ABC, you will get B into AC is ABC. Plus, you multiply, so you multiply B with AC, ABC, then you multiply B plus C bar into D, BD plus B, C bar, D. This one, B, C bar, D. If I multiply B into B, no, I will get B only, then like this, I will get B, B, D. Plus B C bar D. So this I can rewrite it as A plus B D plus B C bar D. I can rewrite the same. No, B B D is B D only. This B B D is B D only. Okay. So next. Here, I take A common, 1 plus BC plus BD, I will take common, 1 plus C bar, that is equal to A into 1 plus BD into 1. So here I will get, what is the answer now? A into 1 is A, BD into 1 is, this is 1, okay? BD into 1 is BD. Answer is A plus BD, A plus BD, okay? Conversion of AND or invert logic to NAND or NOR logic. We need to know some basics. We need to know some basics. And what are the basics? So minimal Boolean expressions are usually obtained in SOP form or POS form. So SOP Oh, yes. What is SOP? Sum of product terms. Write it down. Sum of product terms. You should know this, very important. Or it may be, the boolean expressions may be in the form of product of sum terms. Product of sum terms. Okay. So what do you mean by SOP? Sum of product terms. It is in sum of product term is implemented using a group of AND gates where outputs are OR. And what is POS? Product of sum terms. It is implemented using a group of OR gates and whose outputs are connected with the help of AND gates. Okay. Next we have AO. It is implemented using OR gates. It is implemented using AND OR gates. Next is AOI logic. It is implemented using AND OR NOT gate. Okay. It is implemented using AND gate OR gate NOT gate. AO logic is implemented using AND gate AND OR gate. Okay. So now what is SOP? Students, SOP terms. What is SOP? I will tell you. With the help of an example, I will tell you. So it's very easy. AB plus CD. Okay. AB plus CD. CD plus EF. This is SOP. This is SOP. How do I do it? See here. AND gate AB, AND gate CD, AND gate EF, AND gate. What are these? The output of the AND gates are ORed output. This is an example of SOP. The output of the AND gates are connected to a OR gate. That is SOP. What is POS? I tell you with the help of an example. A plus B, C plus D, E plus F. So we have to implement this A plus B, C plus D, E plus F with the help of OR gate, isn't it? So OR gate AB, OR gate CD, OR gate EF. The output of the OR gate should be connected to a AND gate. So this is POS. See, now exactly opposite. SOP is sum of product terms. Sum of product terms. Here the product terms are generated. AB, CD, EF. What are these? Product terms. We are making a sum. Means we are giving the output of the AND gate to the input of OR gates. Sum of product terms. We are taking the sum of product terms. These are the product terms. A, B, C, D, E, F are the product terms. Sum of product terms. Next, coming to this POS, product of sum terms. That is A plus B, C plus D, E plus F. What are these? These are sum terms. What are these? Sum terms. A plus B, C plus D, E plus F are sum terms. We are taking OR gate. So these output of OR gate are connected as input to AND gate. Okay. So we are taking a sum terms. These sum terms are generated and then they are ANDed. Here, product terms are generated and then they are ORed together. So SOP and POS. In SOP, first level is AND gate, then it is second level is OR gate. In POS, first level is OR gate, then it is AND gate. So right here in the first level we get AND gates in SOP. In the second they are ORed together. Next in POS, OR gates are first. and then they are added. Okay, and then they are added. Now here examples: A B, C bar D, E F, E bar, F bar. What are these, students? These are product terms. These are product terms. Next examples: A plus B, C bar plus D, E plus F, E bar plus F bar. What are these, students? These are sum terms. Sum terms means these are ordered. No, here ordered, right? These are sum terms. Got it? So next we have sum of product or product of sum. Right? SOP or POS. SOP is first we use AND gate and then you use OR gate. SOP. POS is first we use OR gate and then we use AND gate. So this is POS. Okay? So this is one examples of product terms. A, B, C bar, D, E, F, E bar, F. Product terms. A plus B, C plus D, C bar plus D, E plus F, E bar plus F bar. All these are examples of sum terms. SOP and POS. So these are examples of product terms and the sum terms. Sum of product terms and product of sum terms are taught you in today's class.